Guys, it means we are on to the final set of five songs. These are the last songs in semi-final two. Let's take a look and see what you think.
Oh my God, you got me on. Cause I'm being by the bad things on.
Welkom in Europa, blijf hier tot ik dood ga. Europa, pa, Europa, pa. Welkom in Europa, blijf hier tot ik dood.
There we have it, the last five songs from semi-final two. Let's see. I think there are some absolute bangers in this one. Michelle's nodding and agreeing with me, which means, oh.
Absolute banger alert.
Yeah, definitely.
Got a song for one of them. Do you want to hear it?
No.
I'm going on holiday next week for like forever on a road trip to the Europe. And so obviously the Netherlands... It touched me slightly, and we're going to Europa in my shit.
Oh God, what happened there? Crikey. Michelle, did you have like an auto timer thing on this? Blimey.
Oh, you bastard. Anyway, I love the Netherlands. Do you like the Netherlands?
Oh yeah. I mean, people have been talking about like novelty songs and songs that aren't serious, and there are just songs you like and songs you don't like. It's got a message, you know. It's a fun song, yeah, but there's nothing wrong with fun songs. The songs, they're just as valid as any other song, and this is a bundle of fun, despite Michelle singing.
I'd rather have a song with a message that's fun then like a dreary sort of drag it through the mud. Oh, look at this. Woe is me. Oh, everything's shit. At least put a nice tune to it and do a bit of a dance and stuff. It's brilliant. Makes people listen to your message more.
Yeah, I like Norway as well. Overham. It's sort of traditional instruments again. So, I mean, it's a bit of a love peace formula. But I think this could be another go, eh? You know, it's...
It's really good.
It's traditional, but it's an upbeat and sort of modern twist on it.
I like the rocky, sort of like it goes yeah. in it and you feel the bass and it's really meaty. I like it a lot. I like it a lot. Oh, San Marino.
San Marino. That's a fantastic rock song. I kind of hope they stage
it. Is it a rock song?
Yeah.
No, it's not. It's folksy and metal. We did a show about this.
All right, okay.
It's a mix of fuchsia and folk. It's fuchsia metal. Google
Fair
it.
Enough. All right. But yeah, I hope they keep the skeleton dance outfits that they had in the national final.
And the bald women. Oh, no, we spoilt it now. The bald women that take the gimp mask. Yeah. Oh, yeah, we spoilt it. Don't bother watching it now.
No, I do. Yeah, I like that one. And I also like Nemo, the cove. I love it. It's a little bit sort of chaotic, but it really works.
It was like somebody said, I can sing all the genres of music in 3 minutes. And the drunk mate at the bar went, no, you can't. You're deluded. You don't know what you're on about. And he went, watch this. There you go. That is Switzerland in a nutshell.
Yeah, it's great.
Let's just look at a couple of these comments. So what was it? Europapa is proper scooter vibes or vids. I'm going to go for vibes. Do you reckon that's vibes? I reckon that's vibes.
Yeah.
And also followed up with more tea bicker. Also, what is the fascination of Europa? Sounds like the Crazy Frog song from years ago. Little John UK, a friend of mine who is so into the Netherlands that he's learnt Dutch, can't stand the Dutch entry. It's open.
I'm already bitter about summer in the national selection. Like there was this gem, the last polar pair, and they sent Megara. That's just the last polar, I am the last polar bear. And I'm like, this is a one in a million chance to send this song and go all the way. And you're like, okay. So San Marino, no chance from me. What else do we have here? Malta. She doesn't have this. She doesn't have this aura. Sorry, like she's a lovely girl. She doesn't have this like superstar aura. She's like a, you know, she looks like on a high school talent show. So for me, Malta is no go. Norway, well, it's a weak semi. So Norway has a good track of public votes. So Norway, I mean, it's a good song. It's a good song. As Phil said, it's a second go A type of song. I like it. It's a good vibe. Not my favorite day, of course. I'm still bitter about Kano, Dam Digi Digi Da, not getting this ticket to Eurovision. I will always be bitter about every time Kano is not going through. Nemo, definitely a standout song, Switzerland. But Tom, you know that my famous rants, right, about Cyprus every year, how I back for what?
Oh, yeah, yeah, absolutely.
This year, I didn't use my, opportunity for Cyprus because I saved it for another country. And the country is Netherlands. This song, I've listened, let's say, 100 times. I cried 100 times. And not just listened it. And I watched 1,000 reaction videos. While watching people reacting to it, I cried another 1,000 times. This is how you do a fun, crazy song. It's just not about what. It's not about getting through the semifinal. You can be a joke, it's a gimmick act, but just put a story out there. Tell me why you chose going down this path. And in your case, this is who he is. He's not a one-act show. This is his whole career based on this. So it's organic, it's real. There is an amazing story behind it. And he is genuinely wants this. He genuinely wants to do Eurovision. He volunteered and he prepared and he delivered. So Europapa, I think, is the ultimate representation for Eurovision and for European. And that's the reason why it's the winner for me this year.
Hey, strong, strong words there, Oban. I can't believe, though, that San Marino is the AI song that you've kind of pointed out there. Because quite frankly, for me, it's my AI, Rob. It's my AI. See, you know, that to me, forget Kano.
Oh, come on. Yeah,
that would have been my Norwegian entry. Selena, who I know must have some absolutely superb opinions on at least two of these, because they are going to threaten Belgium for the number one spot in this semi-final.
I have opinions about them. The question is, are they good? First of all, we know that Belgium will give their 12 points to the Netherlands. You can write that down in the newspapers. We're going to give them to them. Is it a song that I like? No. Do I like music from Joost? No. It's just not my genre. I don't like his music. Do I support him? And do I think the Netherlands is funny? Yes. I mean, it's his dream. He worked so hard for it. You go have fun. You go do your thing and have a great score. That's all amazing. But I just don't like the song. And I'm going to get so much hate for it because he is extremely popular in Belgium. It's a funny, funky song. He wants to do Eurovision so badly. He can go to Eurovision now. The question is, will Karja be there? Because he's extremely good friends with Karja. So I'm expecting Karja in one way or another. Norway is growing on me. Don't really like the shouting so much, but it's growing on me. And I forgot the other countries. Oh yeah, Switzerland. It's also very good.
I think Karja could be there. There's a lot of people that like that one. I think that could be this year's winner. I know Brendan wouldn't go in for such things. He's probably picked something far more sensible. I don't know, like Switzerland or Malta.
You'd be wrong. So,
I knew I'd be wrong.
Yeah, well, Malta, it has no substance for me. As Oban was saying, there's just something not right. She hasn't got that aura. It doesn't work. The Netherlands, it's very catchy. A lot of fun. Well, no doubt qualifying it will do well. I don't see anything negative to say about that. It's not my cup of tea, but it is fun. And at least it's you can sing along to it. So you can't ask for much more. As a bitter Keno fan, I prefer not to talk about Norway this year. I'd have even taken me at my AI like you, Tom, but no, I can't stand the wailing on the table, so I'll opt past that one. San Marino, that song just draws you in. I absolutely love it. It is brilliant. It's a fantastic, whatever the word is, metal song. So I think that's going to do well. And again, Switzerland, no, I do not get the hype on that.
Let's just ask you a question. So with Malta, is the problem with Malta not so much the song, but the selection process?
I'm not so sure. Maybe it plays a part in it, but I just think the song and the singer don't match very well. It's trying too hard. Maybe it's trying to copy what other countries have done previously. There seems to be a lot of gaps there for dancing, copying countries from last year especially.
Ian and Donna.
The only one that slightly lets me down a bit, and I'm probably one of the few that actually did watch the Maltese national final, is Malta. It wasn't one of their strongest years this year. And Sarah Bonacci with the loop actually was one of the better entries of the selection.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Go watch it and see. I just think she needs more. There's something missing there. And it does feel like a copy of so many things we've seen before. Substance is lacking. The chorus bit's catchy, and I'm sure she'll have a decent enough dance routine in the middle of it. For me, it's going up against both Cyprus and Georgia, and I think it's going to be the one that people will forget out of those three, unfortunately. Yeah. I absolutely love Norway. Sorry, Kino haters. I actually really did like the ethereal wailing of the lady on the turntable and the good rock track that accompanied it. It was one of my favourites for Norway this year, and I think it will do well. There's nothing else like it, and the only two rock numbers in the whole thing are San Marino and Norway. So, and they're very different from each other, so I can't see them cancelling each other out or anything like that. San Marino as well, Megara, very good group, and their performance at San Marino was actually really strong. So they can only build on that and have a lot of fun with the audience. And I'm looking forward to what they're going to produce. As for the other two, the Netherlands and Switzerland, well, these both made my top 10. Absolutely love them. The one thing that concerns me, though, is how they're going to be staged, because they both have amazingly mental videos that work so well with the song. How are they going to put that onto the stage? And it could be a make or break thing. Switzerland, I suppose, has the stronger lyric, I think, to sort of understand what he's trying to present. It could go one way or the other for me. And I really hope that they do sail through, because they're both fun songs. They both have a good message, and there's an emotional thing going on there. They're both very strong singers, and both with their own style. I just love the fact that it's a total hot mess for Switzerland. Just sing whatever you fancy, mate, and it'll come across nice. I love it. It's great. And Netherlands is quite bonkers, but it's so heartfelt as well at the same time. He's got the energy, and he'll play with the audience so well. I can't see these not qualifying.
Yeah, looking at these, Malta, it's a bit like Georgia Greece, it's shit. Netherlands, I find this song slightly irritating, but when you know the message behind it and what it's saying, it takes on a whole different meaning. My worry is that the audience seeing it for the first time and seeing it probably once won't necessarily get what the song is about and will catch on it as being a bit of a novelty. Ireland's probably got a similar problem. And it might not do well that, because they don't get a chance to learn what's behind it. And what's behind it is really strong, really powerful. Switzerland, similar thing. It is a messy song. There's too many genres going on there. I think it's edging into the just because you can doesn't mean you should. And it just becomes messy, and it jumps around and does a bit of opera and a bit of rap, and then does a bit of the James Bond thing, and then a bit of what the fuck is going on here. It's too much, I think, and it might not come across correctly. There's quite a few songs this year are jumping around genres like that, and they're a bit messy and it doesn't quite work. Exception to that might be Ukraine. It's just better structured. And although it does jump between genres, it does it in a more coherent kind of package. San Marino's great. I'm really glad they won it. It was by far the best song. Although I did love the Polar Bear song. That was one of my favorites.
Yeah.
I really liked that
song.
There's
not enough love for the Polar Bear.
And they are going to be great on stage. AI. They are going to be a really good live performance. And out of this lot, Norway, absolutely fucking brilliant. Absolutely superb. It's unlike anything else in there. You watch the national final, you look at the audience reaction to that song. They loved it. It is brilliant.
They are going to do well this year. And
I really hope so.
What will happen is the Kano fans will again quite bitterly just kind of go, again, sorry. Sorry, Brendan. Sorry, Sean. Let's start with Oban.
My final three qualifiers, since I'm keeping the count, are Switzerland, Norway, and Europa.
See, I've only got you down for five, Oban, so far. I got you down for Austria and Belgium in the first lot, and then Denmark, Estonia, and Latvia. He's got himself on mute, and he looks.
Oh no, I said also Georgia and Greece.
Oh, Georgia and Greece. Oh, yeah. There we go. I stand corrected. Clearly, my maths wasn't that as good as I thought it was.
Not the ears.
I'll teach that then. Phil and Michelle.
Go. Obviously, because I've got 10 fingers, I can count to 10. That all of these are going through.
Even Malta.
Oh no. Well, I haven't got my glasses on, hang on.
No.
Malta. I didn't even write anything for Malta because I thought it was just goof.
So Netherlands.
Yeah, but you need
Netherlands, San Marino, Norway, Switzerland, anything else?
That's it.
All of them apart from Malta, really.
That still leaves you at 9, though, Michelle.
Oh, shit, does it? Because I counted earlier on. Right, I've got Austria, Belgium, Czechia, Estonia, Netherlands, Norway, Latvia, San Marino, Switzerland, and Denmark.
Bill.
Netherlands, Norway, San Marino, Switzerland.
Brendan.
I got three spaces left, so Netherlands, Norway, and San Marino.
Just about. Right, okay. Alina.
I just have Netherlands and Norway, and if I have any open spaces left, just fill in the blank.
Ian and Donna.
Right then. So this is going to be the Netherlands, Norway, San Marino, and Switzerland.
If I've done my sums right, as I didn't do last week, Netherlands, Norway, San Marino, Switzerland.
Who do I think is going to get through? Well, I'll tell you the six I think that won't get through. That's probably easiest. I'm predicting upsets for Armenia, because I don't think they're going to get through. I'm also predicting upsets for Latvia and Georgia and San Marino and Malta. And my surprise non-qualifier is Switzerland. There you go.